an eye and a star. Look at the stars, maybe. Those stone statues seem to rotate with this switch. I wonder what this means. All these papers are riddled with incoherent doodles. Where is this door leading me? They carried these people here to test them, like a challenge of some sort. Where is this door leading me? A shining constellation. I better draw it. Constellations and stars. These people seem to worship otherworldly gods. Circular stones with strange carved symbols. Those icons on the wheel are the same as the constellations I have on my hand. What an odd structure, riddled with nooks and crannies and endless stairways. Maybe it only hurts the first time. Ah! The second also hurts. When I arrived on this island, I felt like I was trespassing. But now, I feel like this is where I belong. Took them to a throne room. That was the final step in the ritual. place is like a labyrinth. It was submerged in black ichor. Harry seems to be on the brink of madness. But I don't feel the slightest hint of confusion. On the contrary, I feel my mind is more focused than ever. Oh, come on. One more time. Ow! That hurt! Again. Another one of those gates. I have to get into the water again. Again? Seriously? Ah! feel the torment of the thousands of slaves who perished here. All the doors are open, but where is the constellation I need to open the throne room? Black and white figures. Good doggies, or dragons, whatever you are. Come on. One more time. Ow! That hurt! Again. Are aligned, forming a constellation that I don't recognize. That is not the same sky you can see from Earth. And if that's not the Earth sky, where am I now? Sanctuary's open. It's time to find out what's waiting for me inside.
Thank you.
There's something written on the floor.
It's blood.
Fall. Haven't I heard that word in my dreams? That's a disturbing mirror. Is it made of black ichor? I feel like it is speaking to me. Oh, heavens! My God. Nothing that happens here appears to respect the most basic rules of physics. However, as strange as it may be, it does maintain a peculiar harmony. Of a clock or a music box.
Harry, is that you?
You perform the ritual. You poor fool. But why? I don't understand it. Why? You knew it. You knew it wasn't going to work.
You knew the ritual wasn't going to work. That's why you never sat on the throne. You didn't even perform the ritual, did you, Harry? But you wanted me to think that you had. You even left a lure to confuse me. But why? What really happened? The person with you in that sanctuary beach was Cassandra. So if you didn't die, it had to be her. Did she use the dagger to open the gates and carry out the ritual? You tried to stop her, but it was too late. She shot you with your own gun and left you for dead, didn't she, Harry? Cassandra was ambitious and would stop at nothing to uncover the secrets here. The island fueled that hunger for knowledge.
had doubts about whether the ritual would work. But what happened to Cassandra cleared up those doubts. The ritual wasn't for people like you. The ritual was only for people like me. But you refused to believe it until the island itself spoke directly to you. Pacha Falgafen. She is our daughter. That's when you finally understood. You understood what my fate would be if I didn't come here and carry out the ritual. A slow and painful death.
So you faked your own demise and left your glasses near Cassandra's corpse. Those same glasses you never take off. And you sent me the package from Diggy and Perry, your picture, the key, the dagger. Another one of your scavenger hunts. And I took the bait. You made me come to this island, the same island where you almost lost your mind and your life. The same island where four members of your expedition perished. Why did you deceive me, Harry? You said you would never lie to me. Why didn't you tell me the truth? Why did you do this to me? Because you knew that I would never accept my fate if it meant leaving you. Right, my love? Not even if staying with you would mean a slow and painful death. So the only way to get me to leave you was to make me believe you were dead. And you chose to live a life without me, so I could be who I really am. That's why you tried to deceive me. But I know you too well, my dear old pal. We've had so many years together, so many moments of love, happiness, understanding, friendship. Oh, beautiful life with you. I know what you tried to do, but I can't let you make this decision for me, Harry. Either I embrace my fate and accept what I've always been, and leave you behind. Or I reject it, and return home with you to relish the time that my illness gives us. It's my decision to make. You were right about one thing, Harry. I would never accept my fate if it meant leaving you. I know who I really am and where I belong. I know fate has eternal life in store for me, but an eternal life without you is worthless, meaningless. So I choose the slow and painful death. I'm going back home. You staged this ruse because you love me. But true love is reciprocal. So I'm also making this decision because I love you. Our love is greater than fate, lineage, or all the pain I can suffer. Whatever time we have left, we'll spend together. When the time comes, it will be your hand that holds mine. And those beautiful blue eyes will be the last thing I see before I leave.
So, you didn't find your husband on that island, Mrs. Everhart?
I did find my husband. He wasn't on the island, though.
But what have you been doing these 3 days, then? What did you find there?
I don't know. The truth about myself, I suppose. And at the same time, the reason to go back home.
I don't think I follow you.
Have you ever been in love, Captain Hodgson?
In love? You mean like in a romance novel?
No, that's fiction, Captain. In real life, true love stories don't end with a wedding. They end with a funeral. And the only thing that eases that final moment of heartbreaking sadness are all the good memories lived together.
Honestly, I don't think I've ever felt anything like that, Mrs. Everhart. But if you love your husband that much, he's certainly a lucky man.
We are both lucky.
Okay, are you ready?
Yes, I'm ready.
One, two, don't forget the harmony. One, two, three.
All my life is empty since I went away. Skies don't seem to be so clear. May some angel sentry guard you while I stray, and fate be kind to join us some sweet day. Oh, how I miss you, dear old pal of mine. Each night and day I pray you're always mine. Sweet.
Just want you only, want you all the while. May God decree I have you back someday. Oh, how I miss you, dear old pal of mine. Each night you're always mine. Sweetheart, may God bless you.
Honey, are you all right?
I'm fine, Harry, don't worry. I can keep going.
No, listen, let's leave it for today. You shouldn't make any unnecessary efforts.
Really, darling, I'm fine.
You need to rest, Nora. Come on, I'll take you to bed.
Even today, so many years later, I still doubt whether I did the right thing. In the end, it didn't matter. You returned home and forgave my deception. We moved close to the sea and had a few more good years, didn't we? Until you left me that one sunny March morning. I wish I could be reunited with you. But fate has punished me with a long and sorrowful life, with no other incentive than my work. Because that is the only thing I have now, my dear old pal.